As we listen to the gospel passage, which is synonymous with Feast of the Virgin Mary, we see the two sisters, Martha and Mary, encountering Jesus in very different ways. Martha, for all intents and purposes, she's like a university student. She's like you. She's running around, she's trying to get everything done. Just as you're trying to get your papers done, just as you're trying to get your finals done, she's going everywhere trying to make it work. And her sister Mary is sitting at the Lord's feet, listening to him. And so Martha gets frustrated, she gets upset. And, "Lord, do you not care? My sister has left me alone. I'm all by myself here. Tell her to help me." And the scripture doesn't assign characteristics in this moment, but we figure that it was one of two ways. Either he said Martha, and she just didn't hear him because she was so busy running around that needed to hear it a second time to stop. "Martha, Martha." Or the Lord said it twice to emphasize to her, "I see you. I understand you." And this is made abundantly clear when the Lord says to her, "Martha, Martha, you are troubled and anxious about many things." Oftentimes in life, especially as college students, you just want somebody to acknowledge what you're going through, to acknowledge that your struggle is real, that you're dealing with that. And so the Lord is doing that. He is not pushing Martha away. He is not invalidating her emotions or her experience. He is saying that he sees it. "You're troubled. You're anxious. You're full of anxiety. You want everything to go right." And for you as university students, it's the same thing. You're stressed. You're anxious. You want everything to go just right so that you can get the highest score, so that you can make the best impression for future employers. You're very, very anxious. And the Lord sees that. He acknowledges that. But he says, "Mary has chosen the good portion, which shall not be taken away from her." Now, what does that mean? It means that you too, all those OCF students that could not be here physically but are watching online, you chose the good portion. You chose to take time away from your studies as you're getting ready for your finals in these last 2 weeks. Come and pray. And the beautiful thing about that is, you might think to ourselves, "Oh, that's time that I could have been spent studying. That's time I could have been spent writing my paper, my finals, my dissertation." And yet, when we give God our time, our ear, our attention, like Mary did, he blesses our effort. He strengthens us for what is to come. I dare say that because you have come today, your efforts will be exceptionally blessed, and that you will do better, better than you might have done, even if you have spent the entire day today studying. Because now you will have the grace from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and from his mother, out of her joy that you came to worship this evening. May Christ our God, through mother, bless each and every one of you as you complete your studies for this semester. May he strengthen you for the next. God bless you all. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.